Now, invisible signals are flying through the air around you. Outside the spectrum of light that your eyes can see, huge radio waves wider than houses carry information between computers. GPS systems, cell phones, and others are actually in play. The signal your phone broadcasts is so powerful, if your eyes could see radio waves, your phone would be visible from Jupiter. At least your own eyes will be able to see that, if the sky is not overwhelmed with interference from service providers and satellites, of course. Printing. People who fly and did not put their phones in flight mode. As you see, this setting is not to protect your trip, but to protect everyone else on your trip's path. Cell phones connect to networks by emitting information in the form of electromagnetic waves, specifically the radio waves that occupy this range of the electromagnetic spectrum. These radio waves come with a range of wavelengths. Imagine that your own eyes see different wavelengths as different colors. When you make a call, your phone generates a radio wave signal it sends to the nearest cell tower. If you're out of service, your phone will consume more power to send a higher strength signal in an attempt to make a call. Once connected, this signal is relayed between cell towers all the way to the recipient of your call. Given that your call is not the only signal here, cell towers that handle calls allocate specific wavelengths to each phone involved in the communications. This is slightly different from the wavelength that your phone receives information on, so that it does not interfere with that incoming signal. But there's only a limited number of colors to choose from. Since the advent of Wi-Fi technology, the demand for owning these wavelengths has greatly increased. With all these signals in the air and a limited number of colors to assign, avoiding interference is becoming increasingly difficult, especially when cell phone towers receive many signals at the same time. Like during regional emergencies, when everyone is trying to use their phones. However, there are other sources of interference that can be more effectively prevented, such as phones looking for signals from thousands of meters in the sky. Phones on planes are very far from cell towers, so they work extra hard to send the strongest signals they can. Searching for service, but given that airplanes travel very fast, phones may find themselves closer to the cell tower than expected, leading to the transmission of a massive signal that obstructs terrestrial signals. So when you travel without using airplane mode, you are actually acting as a blocker for wireless signals like military radios, where massive radio waves interfere with nearby signals. Even on Earth, random radio waves are emitted from all of our electronic devices, which slows down the internet and makes our calls unclear. And this makes consumers pay a higher price for a larger bandwidth. This prompts telecommunications service providers to seize more of the radio spectrum and ultimately send more satellites into the sky, which creates a void cycle that could erase the stars eventually. However, even without these satellites, this system poses a threat to our relationship with the universe. The radio telescopes used in astronomy rely on a certain range of wavelengths to look deeply into space. However, although this range is supposed to be protected, restrictions are not strictly enforced. For example, a group of very large objects can detect signals across our solar system in the range of 1 to 50 gigahertz. But if he tries to search for signals less than 5 gigahertz, his search might be swamped by a sea of phones on 5G networks. No place on Earth is really quiet from radio signals. The satellites that relay signals around the world have covered the planet with radio waves. But there are some places with less crowded skies where radio telescopes can peer deeply into space. Here we can see the black hole in the center of the Milky Way and discover the secrets of galaxies that are up to 96 billion light years away. As long as we are not exposed to the public because of the phones that send first-class signals.